today I want to start bringing in more of the values that we have for our cart, and that's pretty much going to fill out all of this order totals component that we have here. So let's go ahead into the shop and add more items. We'll grab this hoodie, add to cart. We'll also grab, let's see, one of these nice home goods items. That's a good one. We'll pick, well, there's only one. So let's grab another item. Yeah, that's all right. We'll grab two of those, add to cart. Okay, so if you look here, we have some dummy prices still in here, and our quantities aren't quite matching up with what's in the cart, but that's fine. That's something that we're going to deal with later on anyway. I just wanted you to be aware of what's going on there. So let's go ahead and start working on this section right here, this orders total. So the first thing we want to do is go to the cart controller, and then we already have cart items coming in here, but what I want to do is grab this. I want to create a variable and paste that in. So now we can just use the variable down here. The next thing I want to have is the cart tax rate. And this is the cart tax that we configured in our cart configuration file when we installed the shopping cart. I'm going to make sure to leave a link for the playlist to all of the videos that we have for this series in the description. So if you want to go back and refresh, or if you haven't seen it yet, go ahead and check that out. So let's go ahead here and now add cart tax rate. The next thing I want to add is the tax. So here we're also going to use the same config, but instead of it just being that, we're going to divide it by 100. And that's because we're using whole numbers coming from the database. So we want to make sure that we get the correct calculations. The next thing I want here is the cart subtotal. And this package comes with another function called subtotal. And what that will do is, for each individual item, it calculates the tax for that item. So it'll give us the true value of the items without the tax. So let's go ahead and pass that in as well. Something else I also want in here is just the cart tax. And what that's going to do is it's going to take the subtotal, and then it's going to give us that value, the correct value. So it's going to multiply it by our tax config up here. It's going to multiply the subtotal, and that's what we're going to have for the cart tax. Now down here, I just want to have a new total, and that's going to be cart subtotal times 1 plus tax. Again, we're using whole numbers, so we need to make sure that we calculate this. So now we can just copy these, head over to our cart index. We need to accept them here. So these we also need to pass into our order totals component. First one, we're just going to call tax rate. The next will just be subtotal. The next will just be tax, and the next will just be total. So let's copy these and head into that component. And we need to accept them in here. Okay, let's go ahead and start using this in the page, in the component. So here, this is the subtotal. So we're going to format it. Okay, we're going to go down, and we're still hard coding this for now. We'll fix that later, but we can go ahead and add that here as well. the estimated tax, we are going to go ahead and just do we'll do the same for total. Let me just copy this. And now our tax rate will just be tax rate. Okay, let's go ahead and check it out. Okay, so we're getting our subtotals. And as I said, this is for each individual item. So we'll add the prices here in a second, but it's subtracting the taxes from the item price. The other thing that I want to change too is it's not displaying the total here. The tax is correct, or it should be correct. We'll do the calculations in a bit, but let's go ahead, start with this, and then we'll change the prices. Okay, order format total. It's total here. It's total here. New total. New total. New total. Okay, so for now, instead of new total like this, what I'm just going to do is I'm going to take this default and I'm just going to go ahead and use the total function. That's part of the shopping cart package. So now we're getting the correct value. Let's go ahead and add our original prices here. Okay, let's check that out. Okay, cool. So let's just go ahead and check our calculations really quick to make sure that we're accurate. The first one is 6191 times 2, because this item that we have here, this sweater, we have two of them in our cart. Okay, then we add 73 and then 2594. 223.73 is what we're getting for our subtotal here, and that is correct. Now let's check it with our tax. 8.48 divided by 100, and then we're going to times it by 223.73. 1897, that's our tax price, and that's exactly what we have here. So it looks like it's working so far. Let's go ahead and also bring in the cart count. So we have 2, 3, 4, we have 4 items. We want this to be reflected in our cart, and we also want it to be reflected here. So since this navigation is global, what we can do is we can put it in our inertia middleware. So let's go ahead and take care of that now. We search for inertia, handle inertia requests. Okay, go down. In this share function, this is a function that whenever you want to put something and you want to make sure that it's shareable through the front end, you can put it in here. So we already have array merge. In here, we're going to have a cart count. This cart count is going to be that cart instance default. And there's another function on it called count. Okay, let's import this. And it's the facade. Now, if we go and take a look at the browser, we'll go ahead and refresh it, and we'll open up our inspection tools. We go down to view, and we look at all of the properties that we have coming in. So it should be in this inertia tab right here, and props. We're now passing in the cart count, which is 4. So that's something that we can go ahead and put in to our order totals component right here. So let's go do that. Right in here. We can say page, props, cart count. So now this 5 should turn into a 4. Cool. So now we're getting it from the database, which means we can also get it into our navigation component up here. So let's go do that while we're here. Nav component. Here we'll say age props cart count. And we also have, let me copy this. We also have it on the hamburger menu, which is, that is the hamburger menu right here. Okay, so that's the menu for the, we already did it for the hamburger. So now we can do it up here. Let's go and take a look and make sure we have it in both places. Okay, so the first thing we'll check is this one here. It should turn to a 4. Cool, it has. Let's go ahead and make the page smaller so we can check the menu. And 4. Fantastic. The other thing we can do as well is add the conditionals to these titles up here. So your cart is empty and 5 items in cart. Let's go ahead into the cart index and work on that. Okay, so for this, your cart is empty. We can now do BF age props cart count is less than or equal to 0. Then here we'll have a VLS. And then for this 5 that's hard-coded, we can now grab this, paste that in. Let's go see what that looks like. Cool, so now we have 4 items in cart. If you guys are enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. I'm going to push all this code up to GitHub and leave a link for that down in the description, as well as a link to the playlist so that you can catch up on all the videos in this series. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.